मला एकटं वाटतंय,
मला उदास वाटतंय,
मला खूप भीती वाटतीये,
छाती धडधडतंय,
खूप राग येतोय,
झोप लागत नाही,
डोकं सारखं दुखतंय,
कोणाच्या तरी बोलण्याचा भास होतोय,
आत्महत्या करावीशी वाटते.
What does a person who is going through these kinds of problems do? This entire influx of emotions and feelings and thoughts which are surrounding the person can make the person feel very, very helpless. The person can feel stuck. The person can feel trapped. It starts affecting his or her personal life. It starts affecting his or her family life as well as professional life. Now, to counter this, we have taken a learning which has come from the community itself, and that is the learning of coming together as a group. Groups is not an alien concept in the community. The community is a big group of people in which there are many, many smaller groups. For example, there are groups based on religion, on region, on cultural preferences. There are youth mandal groups, there are bachat gat groups, there are temple groups, bhajan groups. We have taken this idea forward and incorporated a therapeutic element into it and formed the therapeutic group work. Now, the therapeutic group work program brings together people having similar mental health problems. Through the process of assessment at our center, we are able to identify what are the individual mental health needs of the person who's come to the center. Once that is done, we are able to identify what kind of techniques would best suit that person to come out of his or her own mental health problems. Whether the person needs to be sent for individual counseling, whether the person needs to be sent for individual arts-based therapy, support counseling, lay counseling, or if the person will benefit from group work or group therapy. Once this is done, our field workers make contact with the individuals and introduce the idea of groups. They speak to them about the benefits of being in the group. They speak to them about coming together with people who are facing similar kinds of problems and working together to acquire the capacity, knowledge, and skills that will help them overcome their mental health problems. The person takes some time to think about whether he or she wants to be a part of this kind of a group. Once that is done, recruitment to the group is on a voluntary basis. Once all individuals have been identified and the recruitment is done, we are ready to move to the next step, that is actually starting the group work sessions. The group work program also encompasses a research component. The assessments that we do serve as a pretest or a baseline study of the mental health state of being of the individuals who are a part of the group. Post closure, the individual goes through a similar kind of an assessment so that we are able to map the person's movement through group work therapy. We also do a lot of groundwork before actually starting the sessions. This involves trainings on many different subjects that we would be taking up during the course of the group work, including mental health facilitation, do's and don'ts in the groups, including things like contracting and consent, taking individual consent for the group work process. As a part of our trainings, we spend a lot of time in making the session plans, rehearsing, as well as developing some self-practices. Once the individuals in the group come together, we are able to determine what are the mental health priorities for this group. The mental health priorities become the objectives. We then move on to thinking about what activities or techniques we would like to take in the group so that we are able to achieve these objectives. A facilitator and a field worker anchor that particular group, while the facilitator involves himself or herself in conducting the session, the field worker plays the role of an observer. The observation is done based on certain indicators that are developed beforehand. Sessions are taken once a week. 20 to 25 such sessions are conducted. Every session goes on for about an hour or an hour and a half. After about 20 to 25 sessions, we start preparing the group for closure. In those 20 to 25 sessions, we cover a variety of mental health topics, including self, emotions, thoughts, communications, nutrition, and the body. While the facilitator meets the group once in a week, the field worker is in constant touch with every member who comes to the group through way of home visits. The field worker makes about 2 to 3 home visits every week to every individual who comes into the group work sessions. By making the home visits, dual purpose is solved. One, the field worker is able to understand the client's story outside of the group work sessions. We get to understand the context from which the client is coming. Two, we are able to assess whether the person is being able to practice the things that he or she has learned through the group work sessions. We also do make referrals to other kinds of services, additional services that the person may require. Referrals are made either in our own team or to other organizations, governmental as well as non-governmental. Towards closure, we start speaking to members about how they would like to take the sessions forward, whether they would like to meet independently, whether they would like to meet at all, and if they do meet, then what are the things that they can do together as a group. Some level of hand-holding is done by the person who has anchored the group as a facilitator. Post-closure, the group continues to meet once in 15 days and serves as an excellent resource for developing many of them as resident community mental health volunteers. So what are the benefits of a group? Why groups? Well, there are many advantages to working with a group. It is time effective, it is cost effective, and you can address issues of many people all at one go. Our research studies and testimonies of many group members have shown that compliance to groups is high and the recovery is much more sustainable for a longer duration of time. People become more self-reliant, people become more self-confident and assertive in their lives outside of the group. Groups provide a safe ground on which they can learn, practice and rehearse new things. There is a concept of sharing and caring in the group. So they not just learn from each other, but they also help each other to learn. They get empowered with a basket of skills. For example, with regard to self-healing skills, if I am a group member and I have been attending the sessions, slowly and gradually I start filling up my basket of self-care skills. And if something happens in my life, some event or some crisis comes up, I know what I have learned and I know what is there in my basket at my disposal. So I just have to pick up one technique and use it. They become independent and start practicing things by themselves at their homes. Group members support and encourage each other. There is a joint learning. People are concerned about each other, they care about each other, and there is also a great deal of hand-holding. Nobody puts them down. Everyone has more or less the same stories. So they know that, you know, it's okay to make mistakes. They don't have to be scared about making mistakes. They become much more accepting of others. They start making friends, start trusting others, and because they come from the same community, the trusting and the friendships, they start spilling over into their daily lives. They meet each other outside of the groups and slowly they are able to develop small circles of care around themselves. They start feeling much more happier, much more at peace, protected, safe. They know that there are people around to support them. They know that there are friends whom they can count on and, you know, who care about them.